Pika kaple blo fam se ni le wa le we ni le dasi kabli ni dasi no lo wa dasi no le lo crahi here le la no me pie nene ni I ka ba pe sku no nge yo lo I pa ni pe ni chano ni chano I ha ni shum
Ninety-three, ninety-two, only Palingo, only 493. Nanny 485 for peon physician and physician's assistant. Nanny 493 peon in a first year in a legal and in a law school. In a law school peon. Law a honey in a ingame here. Nicomena Lipo, I'm going for a bullet. Sack back on a valley came for. Lan and Oquale family planning. Ejun no kone ehi wa we. Ne wa bi o me na macho wi o me ka je 13 years ka ya me. Esane wa hana le poka no ko nge na cheke nyumu ka yo ke bua. Kone ka le wa de me ke ne ne nga mi ne hin jiro ne. Mo le che mo mo ni ne ka fun kwa ibi o de ka ibi ile ka bi nyasi hin. La wa o ni wa na ma mi ness. Ne ye bua mo. Ne e chomo ne na ma pe. Kone wa kun le no yan ko ka ju kun sin kan hun e jo ka ju kun kan hun e o loko ka le ma nyin sin e da kan agbozo se ko ka bi obe kan hun e obi yin no ka le ma yiko mo no lo hin kan wa bi yin me wa ko wa bi o me pe hun e ko ni wa de me ne gba lo yi o me hun o e sa na ahun nu o me a le he ko ko ne ko ya pe mi o mi mo po le ma choose ni ne sa na yi o ne pi o ne ko na anonge yo perform lo ibu ajo wa we lo anti nene ma so hunji ka ba ni ko nga na gbozo ni ka me pe free ni ka me chabonya lo ke ji ole me ma de nwe ke anti ness oni anale tututu o enga free pe ko ya e ma wo nya mu o e ma hanu bu ama jo lo wa o ke pe han mo po no ko po bi le e no ke no kita lo ipo pe mo chu nka
insulin to work on the food you have eaten to get into your body as energy. So those people will have the type 1 diabetes. So for such people, you have to give them insulin into their body to be able to use to break down the starch that they eat. So those children, they are born with it. So they give injection, they take injection in their body, that insulin injection to break down the fat. Other group are adults. You have been born well, you have your pancreas, your insulin is working well. But for diseases or other things we cannot explain, the body is not able to produce enough insulin now to help you break down the starch that you eat. So that's the type 2 diabetes. You were not born with it.
Mm-hmm. Say your kind of banana, my bank kind of banana, hey Joe. I don't bet you any a producer that my insulin law, you need pure insulin of food, let you see to me and your baby. Rehane, a banana, diabetes, a lucid, you know, an orgy in your neonate.
So for those people, we give them either tablets or they still take injections to help break down the starch and then the body can absorb the sugars that they take. So to prevent diabetes, there are so many things we must do. The first one is we must eat a balanced diet, full of vegetables, full of fruits, full of fiber. The contomery, the vegetables add to your diet. Don't eat only carbohydrate diets.
You
add it to the carbohydrate. The other thing is to exercise. If you just sit at one place, you eat, you finish eating, you sleep, the body cannot break down the sugars that you have eaten, the starch. So you must exercise, you must walk, you must, after especially the evening meal, Don't just eat and get to bed. Walk and break down the sugar that you have, the starches that you have eaten to prevent diabetes.
Okay.
Thank you.
No, see here long back me up. I'm telling her she should run. Not that one. Zako exercise or lay here. Oh, only a compound, my name, put the work. Oh, for him, your book. Then you know, good. Oh, you get in your coming.
This program, we wish to engage with the community. We want to have the community get closer to the college. The college is located here, and want the people of the Port Township to feel an ownership in it. Now, beyond that, this is also an opportunity for people who, by their work schedule and other circumstances, cannot get access to healthcare easily, to get screened for particular diseases. And here, we're talking about blood pressure, diabetes, eye, glaucoma, but with particular attention to that. So this is an opportunity to for the community members who are who don't have that chance to get opportunity. So here, if you come here, we have a lot of bee stands have been put up where people are getting the opportunity to get screened for these conditions.
I volunteered to be part of this program because one, as health professional, one of the secondary preventions that we need to be doing is to be screening. And screening is a secondary prevention method. Unfortunately, our busy schedule made it so difficult for us to be organizing screening exercises. So when I heard that we're supposed to be part of this screening process, I quickly volunteered and I was really excited about this. Most people have conditions. Unfortunately, the conditions they have, they do not seek medical care. And it's difficult. Most of them come in a very, very bad stage. A stage when even managing the case becomes so difficult. So screening helps us to pick the conditions very early. And I just saw it as an opportunity to be part of this and quickly help them in picking the conditions very early. Then we just picked somebody who had a very high sugar. The person has never gone to the hospital before. So this gave us the opportunity to help the person, advise the person on what to do early enough to prevent the condition from becoming more severe and more complicated.
We were invited by Ensign College to join in this community-based screening for the people. We have some programs we run at Engage Now Africa, and we thought it would be best if we help them and we collaborate with them to do their program. We actually like helping the remote areas. That's our main focus. But we have other programs running in the cities. Yeah. So if you look at our programs, we have something like the literacy program. So we help train the adults, those who didn't have the opportunity to educate themselves. So we train them on basic reading and writing skills. And then we also have other programs like self-support. After they leave the literacy, we enroll them on the self-support. We teach them about businesses. And then those who qualify, we help them with some form of financial assistance. Though they pay back. So we help them run their businesses and then to strengthen their families. We also do education, like the orphans who can't afford their school fees. We help them pay, though they also pay back, but in the form of tokens, something small, so that the program will be sustainable. So far, I think we are getting a lot of referrals from the eye screening. I think they are screening for glaucoma. So we try to help those who can't afford the medicine, the drugs, so that we'll see how best we can subsidize for them. Those who have health insurance too, we try to advise them to go to the hospital for further tests.
I really like to help people, and helping people is one of my things. From since I was a child, I always find myself, you know, helping and do things for children, and the Bible said that that is what we should do. Because I think of myself in this same position, if I had need help and, you know, I was homeless or stuff like that, I would like somebody to help me too. I didn't know what it is to don't have. So I think that is one of the reasons why I'm involved in this thing too. And I go to different communities, different countries, and I do this. But what embarked me most is just, I just love to help children.
Lihona Children's Foundation takes care of malnourished children in the LDS community and its friends. That is the matter they say. And actually when Ensign said he was organizing a health, community health program, they thought that will be part of it, and that will help get some of the malnourished children in the community. And we are happy to do that.
Days for Girls is an organization. We take care of girls and women. We teach about reproductive health. We teach about hygiene, menopause, and a whole lot of package in this Says for Girls program. We don't just give them the kids, but we teach them a whole lot of reproductive health. And at the end of it, you teach them about self-defense, how they can defend themselves if any man wants to take advantage of them. Public health is very important. Hitherto, very little attention had been paid to public health in this country, and by and large, it's gaining more ground. More people are beginning to understand the importance of public health and the impact it's making on the lives of people. Because public health is not just you going to the hospital and getting treatment, but it's a holistic approach to the health of the population.
It's making me understand that helping the society is very much seen most when you promote health and then prevent disease, because that is the basis. When someone is healthy, the person is able to live, to be able to work and do whatever he has to do on a daily basis.
C-H-O-F-A-L-D-H-L-E-W-O-N-N. Okay, that's what I can see.
And I must say, I'm so glad to be part of such a program today. We've actually given back to what society expects from us. We've gone through the 2 years program of public health. We've learned a lot, and we felt like today being a day like this will give us that opportunity to kind of educate the public, do some health screening and all that. And then we hope that they'll kind of also propagate the good news when they go home from what they've had from us here.
I thank them very much. Because it's a fine thing, taking upon themselves to come and help the public. It's a fine thing, and I feel this must be repeated regularly after, say, 2 weeks or monthly.
What actually motivated us to come into the community was the need to fulfill our social corporate responsibility. As a school which is located in the Lower Manya Municipality, we felt it was important we fulfilled our social corporate responsibility by engaging the community members and then embarking on this health screening exercise. We have seen from the results of this outreach program that yes, there will be a need for us to move on to other communities in the near future. But Ensign is located in this community, and as an institution, you need to start from the known to the unknown. Public health is essential. It is crucial for all of us to take our health seriously. We need to be healthy in order to be productive. So we will encourage every person to once a while go for a screening in order to know his health status.